Alexa, give me a local news update.
Hey, here's your news. Your news news.
In other news, with only a couple of weeks left before the end of the legislative session in Augusta, lawmakers are looking at a last-minute bill that would introduce a red flag law here in May. The proposal from House Speaker Rachel Talbot Ross is titled An Act to Enact the Crisis Intervention Order Act to Protect the Safety of the Public. It would allow family members to go straight to a judge and request that firearms be taken away from someone if they're suspected to pose a significant danger to themselves or others. Right now, under Maine's yellow flag law, police have to start the process of removing a person's guns by first taking that person into protective custody. Senate President Troy Jackson supports the red flag proposal and says he hopes it could be used in combination with the existing yellow flag law.
My intention is not for the yellow flag to go away. I know it's flag lies and it continues to do that. What I think is that we can have both of these bills as tools for what that there is a problem.
If this bill does pass, Maine would join 21 other states that currently have red flag laws. There was an emergency city council meeting tonight in Lewiston. Councilors accepted their resignation as city administrator Heather Hunter. News Remains Paul Small has the story.
After more than 2 hours in executive session, Lewiston city councilors held a public vote right here to make two big administrative decisions. A surprise ending to a meeting that was originally meant to be closed off to the public. This first vote was whether to accept the resignation of Heather Hunter, the Lewiston City Administrator.
We appreciate your years of service to the city and we wish you the best.
Hunter's letter of notice was sent in Thursday. It comes after several department heads that reported directly to her resigned in the last year. And, according to the Sun Journal, several Lewiston officials have recently criticized her for her leadership styles.
Yes.
Two counselors were not present, but of the six that were, five voted to accept her resignation and one voted against. Counselor Erin Sol LeClaire did not answer questions about why she voted no, and all counselors decided not to go on camera after the meeting. However, Counselor Joshua Najim did tell me he believes many members were fond of Hunter, emphasizing they were reluctant to accept her resignation and only did so to prevent leaving a vital role vacant.
I move that the council appoint Deputy Administrator Riley O'Malley as acting city administrator effective immediately.
This was the second vote, which passed unanimously, filling Hunter's position temporarily with current Deputy Administrator Brian O'Malley, while the city searches nationwide for a permanent replacement.
Now, counselors say there will be another meeting regarding these decisions on Tuesday, April 2nd, and more details will be released at that time. In Lewiston, Paul Small, News Center.
Someone ever told you a terrifying true story that was just